This is the Comics Alternative Kickstarter, discovering the North Star, the emancipation of Frederick Douglass. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Comics Alternative Kickstarter. This is the weekly show where I talk with a creator or a creative team who has a recent comics-related Kickstarter campaign going on. And this week I have the pleasure of talking with Baron Bell and Coy Turnbull. They are the creative team behind the Kickstarter project The North Star, The Emancipation of Frederick Douglass. Baron, Coy, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And let's start the ball rolling by having me ask you guys, what is the North Star all about?
Well, the North Star is a 90-page graphic novel, which is the first volume in a 3-volume set that's going to span the life of Frederick Douglass, a great abolitionist and statesman. It's going to be pretty much focused on 3 pivotal moments in his life, and those moments will be more narrative than just historical fact. But you will also have flashbacks that will cover a lot of his historical life. It's an adaptation of his autobiography, The Life and Times of Frederick Douglass.
Okay. So now, Baron, you have adapted Frederick Douglass's autobiography, and Coy, you're the illustrator?
Yeah, I'm an illustrator on the book, and basically my idea for the book is just about making, I guess, his words breathe, because that was the reaction I had when I was reading his autobiography initially, you know, the first volume. It took me by the heart. It took me by, I didn't believe that I had feelings for a person who lived, 100 years before me and 100 and so years before me, and basically grabbed me like he was a family member. And I want to be able to, you know, express that illustratively, because I think his story is one that, you know, when you're reading it, you feel every single moment that he's going through, when he's escaping freedom, when he feels like he has to express what it's like to be a slave, and the feeling of being a slave, not just the idea of it, because I think at the time people knew what it was and may have run across it, but I think the idea of living as one, I think people needed to hear that, and that's the power that I want to be able to express in this project.
Well, where did this idea come up for the North Star project? What's its genesis?
Well, I think it was last year. I'm a voracious reader, especially of history, and I was looking for something to read, and I actually ran across The Life and Times of Frederick Douglass. And I said, okay, I know, you know, what most people know about Frederick Douglass, which is not that much. And so I said, you know, I want to read it. And so I actually sat down and read it. And actually, there's three volumes, I think, covering written at different times of his life. And so I read all of them, and my mind was just completely blown. I said, how do I not know this? There are parts of his life that are just unknown. And so in thinking that, and being an artist myself, I published a book a few years ago called Radio Free America, and Coy graciously did the cover for that one too. So I was talking to my publisher, and I said, I want to attack this because I looked out there and I didn't see anything that was relevant in terms of comic representation or graphic novel representation of Frederick Douglass. And also being an educator, I have a PhD in education. I said, well, you know, this is something that is a necessary asset for today's generation. Visually representing Frederick Douglass in a very fresh, new, and kinetic way, like you can in a comic book, I thought, man, that's going to be a great resource for teachers or even just an average reader to be able to easily enter into this world and hear not just history, but a great story about a man who overcame adversity to rise up to become a statesman. So that was the ultimate genesis of the book. And then once I thought about it, then I said, do I actually have time to do all the artwork myself? I'm like, no, I don't. I'm a college professor. So I said, I need to reach out to my man, Coy, who he was the first person I thought of, actually, because, you know, of the great work he did on Radio Free America and the fact that he's such a great guy. And so I reached out to him, and it was almost as if we were, you know, kind of, it was like a mental telepathic connection.
It was telepathic because we were right at the same point at the same time. It felt like at the same time that I guess he was coming up with this idea, I actually was dreaming about this idea in terms of drawing his story, because I keep a volume of his book around me at all times. I must have read it numerous times, particularly his first writing. Because his first writing to me has the urgency of the moment. Mm-hmm. And to me, I've wanted to, the first time I read it, I had such an emotional reaction to it that I actually was seeing visions of it, like for days after reading it. I read the book in 2 days, and I can actually see visuals of it. I read that when I first moved out here to California, and it was a pivotal time in my life because it was like figuring out myself at that time. And that book put the urgency of life in me right then and there. It was like, you know, yes, we're here, but pay attention. That was one of the things that I guess he expressed all through the book. And it's like, it's one thing, I think, you know, to see it in words. People love to read, you know, I mean, including myself, what am I talking about? Love to read or a description of a time. But I think also seeing it visually, like how we see these shows like Hell on Wheels and Copper, you know, from BBC a few years ago, stuff like that puts us in the time. And that's what our, you know, our goal with this book is to do, is to put people in that time visually.
So in adapting Frederick Douglass's memoir into comic book form, did you refer to any, let's say, previous comics adaptation of Frederick Douglass's story, or did you know of any?
You know, it's funny because when I was a kid, I had read this, what I thought was a pamphlet, but you earlier, actually, you know, before the recording of this show, put me on to Golden Legacy comics of that time, you know, where they created a ton of other African-American biographies into graphic form. And I mean, I got to say, that's my childhood. I guess seeing that, I would like to be able to put something together that's just as powerful as that. Because here it is, I'm 41, and that story I still remember. I still remember reading it. I still remember the classroom that I was in order to read that book. So I would like to do something that's powerful for kids, you know, in that respect, you know, to give them the same feeling that I had.
You know, there's that, and there's also something that I just remembered. There is actually a Classics Illustrated adaptation of the narrative of the life of Frederick Douglass. But again, as with most Classic Illustrated issues, it's not that long. So I guess what you guys are attempting to do with North Star is include to create a more substantive adaptation of Frederick Douglass's life. In other words, a little longer than what you'd find in the Golden Legacy or the Classics Illustrated series. Right. So about how long will this first book be? Because you say this is the first of what will be three?
Yeah, the first book is 90 pages in length. And, you know, I mean, it's like, how do you encapsulate the life of a person, especially someone like Frederick Douglass? I mean, we could do 10 volumes, but, you know, we're only doing three. And they're going to cover, you know, him as a young man escaping slavery, him as a middle-aged man, you know, owning his own newspaper and becoming an abolitionist with William Lloyd Garrison and that whole era of his life. And then the end of his life, as he has achieved the emancipation of slaves, and it's like, now what next for Frederick? And that carries us to the end of his life.
Okay, so let's talk about some of the particulars of your Kickstarter campaign. This will end on Friday, March 23rd. So from the time that this episode goes up, listeners have, I guess, what, roughly about 3 weeks where they can check out and then back the North Star.
Yes.
And then tell me a little bit about the rewards levels that you have.
So our rewards are primarily just different amount packages of the book that you can actually get. So, for instance, we start out with the digital PDF that you can get at the, I think it's the $15 level. So you're going to get a digital PDF and some digital wallpaper as well. At $25, you'll actually get a physical copy of the book, plus a digital PDF copy for your iPad. This seems to be the most attractive level for the people that we've seen who became donors of the book, which is fine, which is absolutely fine. But, of course, we have a $50 level. And you will receive two signed trade paperback versions of the book. At the $25 level, I'll also sign it, and Coy will sign it too. So we'll have two books at the $50 level, and a poster that you can have, a digital poster for your desktop from Coy. And then at $75, you'll receive three signed paperbacks of the North Star, high-resolution poster from Coy. That'll be actually a physical copy, and special thanks on the Terminus Media website, which is the publisher. $100 is the collector's pack. For this level, you'll receive three signed trade paperback novels, high-resolution poster, and our limited edition North Star T-shirt. We have it's going to be basically a T-shirt version of the image that's on the heading of the North Star Kickstarter page, the blue and the red with his face on it. So I actually got a couple of requests for that even before this has been over. But pledge at $100 and you'll get that. $150, I call it the pay it forward level, because my thing is this book is so important that you should want to get it for a couple of kids in your neighborhood or your own kids. At this level of support, you're going to get a pack of five signed trade paperback graphic novels. So that's going to be something that is going to be great to have, if you maybe have maybe you're a youth leader or you have some kids at your school that you want to just say, hey, man, this is a great story. And you just buy the books and just give them away to the kids. Mm-hmm. So that's another thing. $300. I call this like the educator pack. In this pack, you're going to receive 9 signed trade paperbacks of the book and one teacher's guide. So that's one thing that we're also doing. We're trying to really push this towards the school districts, libraries, youth service organizations as well. So at $300, this is a great level for teachers. $500, this is where you get all the collector's items at the $125 level. But in this level, at the $500 level, you're going to get 3 hardcover North Star books. So those are going to be limited edition. So we're going to have a couple of those. At the $500 level, you get everything from the collector's edition plus the 3 hardback books, as well as some posters. At $1,000, you get everything. And in addition to that, we're going to put you in the book, too. put your likeness in the book. You send us a picture of you. I'll send it to Coy, and Coy will find some place creatively to insert you in that book.
No.
Hopefully not a slave owner.
Yeah, hopefully please, not please, a slave owner. Maybe someone on the streets of New York or something like that.
So, yeah, you have a variety of reward levels there for people to choose. But as you mentioned, I guess the core of your rewards, $15 for the PDF and then $25 for the physical copy. And as you mentioned, you already have quite a number of backers on those.
Yeah.
Again, I want to mention that the deadline for supporting the North Star, the Emancipation of Frederick Douglass, is Friday, March 23rd, and that's at 2:57 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So definitely, all my listeners should check out the North Star Kickstarter campaign and then back it for any one of the reward levels that you guys have set up.
Specifically, it's the North Star, the Emancipation of Frederick Douglass. So I think there's another Frederick Douglass project that was on there. So we just want to make sure that that we are very specific.
Okay. And I will include links to your Kickstarter campaign in the show notes, as well as samples of Coy's art.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, Coy, Baron, I want to thank the both of you for taking the time and being on this week's Kickstarter episode. Good luck with everything.
Thank you so much.
Oh, sorry, Baron. Go ahead.
No, we appreciate your time and consideration.
Sure. And I will be back next week talking with another Kickstarter creator. Until then, have a nice weekend.